A man who is into a business that's a combination of beauty and price, who deals with pearls, diamonds and gems, while holding close to his heart the queen of gems and the gem of queens, the pearls. Bahrain's renowned gemologist and jeweler, Mohammed Hussein Malem. A young man who stopped by in Bahrain on his way to Germany in the early 80s, decided to take a walk in Manama, which changed his mind, and today Bahrain is home to him. Founder and Managing Director of Al Siraj Jewelers, Al Siraj Goldsmiths, Al Siraj Diamond Center, Al Siraj Pearls and Al Moalem Gems and Jewels, Mr. Malem is a resident for almost 40 years. At the Bahrain Chamber of Commerce and Industry, Mr. Malem held the office of the Vice Chairman on its Pearl and Jewelry Committee from 2013 to 2017 prior to being a member. He was also the Treasurer of the GCC Gold and Jewelry Association. Over the years, Mr. Malem has also made a mark in the social front and is a go-to person for the members of the Indian community and beyond. The former Vice Chairman of Indian Community Relief Fund and the 2 times former President at the Indian Club, Mr. Malem is the founder and first president to 2 societies, Tamil Social and Cultural Association and Bharati Association. On BizTalk this evening, sharing some pearls of wisdom and about his diamond-studded success story that did not come so easy is Mohammed Hussein Malem. Pearls, diamonds and gems. A man who deals with such shining stories every other day is with us this evening to tell us the tales of his success. Gemologist and businessman Mohammed Hussein Malem joining us this evening on BizTalk from BMC Global Life. Mr. Malem, good evening.
Good evening
and welcome to,
you, to
the show.
Thank you very much. Thank
you. It's as always a pleasure to have you on this platform. A platform which shares with the public success stories of business leaders.
It's an honor to be with you, with this BMC channel.
Thank you very much, sir.
I always want to share my experience, whatever you call it, with audience. It's an opportunity for me.
Great. And 4 decades is not a mean time. And indeed, you must be having a lot to tell us. But in this limited span of time, let's quickly go through Malem the man, Malem the businessman, and Malem the success tale. So let me begin with the business aspect. 40 years, founder and managing director of Al Siraj, a group of Al Siraj establishments, and the Al Moalem Gems. It's very interesting a subject, not only for a woman, but also for a man, gems,
definitely,
jewels.
Yeah.
You get to see a lot of them. What brought you into this business? Was this a family business?
It is, yes. In a certain extent, it's a family business. But we made it in a wide, bigger scale. It was, my father was in Malaysia, was doing this business in a smaller level. But when I entered into it, we made it in a bigger level. So we expanded in every aspect of jewelry trade. Like as you said now, we are one of the biggest dealer in Bahrain as well as Gulf. For biggest, not only bigger, I can say we are a pioneer in wholesale diamond dealing, you know, colors, gems dealing, like what you call ruby, sapphire, those type of things. And we added pearl also because being in Bahrain. And we are originally those days, I mean 100 years, 150 years, from a pearl bed of one of the famous pearl bed, Gulf of Mannar. That is where between lies between Tuticorin and Sri Lanka. This is called the Gulf of Mannar. It used to give one of the best pearl in the world.
Right.
All Bahrain pearl as well as Gulf of Mannar pearl respected equally.
Okay.
With a very small difference between them. The Tuticorin pearl, which I am talking Gulf of Mannar, is more whitish in color, more luster in. That is loved by Europeans very much, European royalties. Whereas our Bahrain pearl is with a little bit of golden touch, yellow tinge, which is loved by Indian royalties. So that's why all the Indian business people, you may come across lot of old family stories. They came to Bahrain from India to buy this pearl. Whereas Europeans came to India to buy those. I mean, I'm talking about 18th century and 19th century, 20th century to buy Indian pearls. Unfortunately, we are not so lucky to have a royalty like Al Khalifa. You know, in India, nobody cared this and the bed is completely dried up.
Oh, very sorry.
Not even single pearl is produced today.
Really?
Yes. Whereas in Bahrain, the wisdom of our four rulers, Sheikh Isa's father, Sheikh Isa, then followed by our current majesty, they are maintaining that control over the pearl diving, pearl fishery, you know, keeping control that, you know, that in the world, only Bahrain is banned selling of cultured pearl. Yeah, it is an offense if you sell cultured pearl. Other than real pearl, any pearl, now there is cultured pearl, there is freshwater pearl, this cannot be imported into Bahrain and cannot be sold into the customer. That is the reason that Bahrain pearl bed are protected, the pearl stocks are protected.
So that the Bahrain pearl bed retains its natural...
Yes, and also government is doing lot. His Majesty's government doing lot to protect that Bahrain stock, which is already in the hands of people as well as in the seabed. It's a big subject. If I go, it will go too much on the pearl.
Yes.
So that is what I am. We came here in 82. I came here. I still remember the day of August 5. It was the highest
temperature.
Yes,
summer.
It was recorded summer, August 5. I opened my business in December. So I took 3 months. It is not aimed at my thing already published also, my story. I didn't aim at Bahrain and to come to Bahrain to open the business. I was going to Germany as my father pushed me to this trade. I was preferring Germany. There is a small town called Idar. It is known for gem trade those days. Center of gem trade for wholesale. So on the way I came to Bahrain. I stayed here 3 days with my friends was here at the time. So I was going around. The first incident from the airport, I told them I'm hungry. Take me to a restaurant.
Okay.
They brought me Lauh restaurant, which was in Shara Sheikh Abdullah Road. So I got down. I saw the whole street full of jewelry, full of. No more. Not like that.
Okay.
Whole street full of jewelry. So it was astonishing. You know the view. So I told my friends, I'm not getting in now, I want to walk a little bit. I walk. The next day I landed there, third day I landed there. I found at the time there was 2,000 workshops and plenty of
jewelry workshops.
Plenty of shops, full stock. I'm talking about 82.
80s, yeah.
But I checked about gem dealer, none, zero.
So I even this was gold jewelry, you're talking
about? Yeah, I'm talking about only gold jewelry.
Okay.
But there is no one gem dealer at the time. So I felt my opportunity is open here.
Okay.
So I convinced my father.
The businessman's eye, okay.
Yeah. So I am here. That is my story. So we started in 82, December.
So at that time, even the locals did not have any gem stores? You mean Bahrainis?
No, nothing. I'm not talking about expatriate or locals. My view only Bahrain business. There was not a single shops. It's a record. It's published by many magazines.
Al-Siraj Jewelers.
We are the first one. And we are the first one in the whole Gulf as a professional gem dealer.
Okay.
But it was very tough for us to establish. It was very tough.
But I was about to ask you, like, how were the initial years?
Oh, you no need to, that is almost 2-3 years. You are not even able to get our rent or my expenses.
Mm-hmm.
You are totally, it took almost more than 5 years to reach break even. The first 2-3 years was very tough.
But what made you stick on to it?
Well, it is the passion.
Mm-hmm.
And some encouragement from some business people in Bahrain. Some of them are alive now, mm-hmm. some of them passed away.
Mm.
I don't want to take everybody's name.
Yes.
That's they keep on encouraging. And myself very much resolved that we will fight to the end. And even in between, my father was discouraged.
Mm.
But I told him, don't worry, I will succeed. This way, we came in to third year, fourth year, the business started to pick up. Because
mm-hmm.
the gem was not used in jewelry manufacturing in Bahrain. That is a big drawback.
Mm-hmm.
Those days, those big jewelers like Asia Jewelers, they were importing directly the manufactured jewelry from Italy. India market, diamond manufacturing, diamond jewelry market, none at the time.
Mm.
Diamond market was small. Mostly diamonds were manufactured the time in Belgium, places. So these jewelers in Bahrain, they were importing from Swiss, Italy, Hong Kong. So no manufacturing activities were happening. I was originally a wholesaler.
Mm-hmm.
My job is to supply to the manufacturer and jeweler who can manufacture the jewelry. So that is the reason I felt very tough to put my leg. So slowly I took the samples to the workshops. Then we introduced the items. So slowly it picked up.
Over the years, which do you think proved more feasible? The gems, the jewelry shops, or the pearl business? Which was?
The jewelry shop is more feasible and more easy.
Mm-hmm.
It is like selling apparels. You can get ready-made easily, either import or locally made. But the challenge is procuring the real gems and the real pearl is always a challenge. So anybody can do a jewelry business. You can tomorrow can start a jewelry trade.
Mm-hmm.
But starting a gem, original gem with maintaining reputation, it's a big challenge.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm enjoying that.
Okay.
So something you know, you need a challenge. Just like eating halwa, it is not life. Life must be with challenges.
Okay. So that's a great message to begin with businessmen. Mohammed Hussain Malim joining on BizTalk from BMC Global Life. I'm sure you'll have many inspirational episodes in your life which you can share with the budding businessmen, isn't it? Especially the grit that you showed to stick on 2 to 5 years. I don't think the younger generation would.
Yeah, that is true. That is true. But it's not that much negative also I'm seeing with the younger generation.
Okay.
Especially Bahraini community, younger generations are big change we are noticing.
Okay.
Oh, big change we are noticing when compared with the 80s, 90s. Now, the Bahraini generation, I am talking particularly Bahraini generation, the reason I am seeing a lot of new entrepreneur entering into the line, especially in my line, too many. And in between, when I was in the chamber, I was in another institute, we trained Bahrainis, we saw the product in front of us, the result of the our effort. The so many Bahrainis who attended our courses, they all enter into the business, most of them.
Okay.
And they are struggling, but they are coming up. Nowadays, what you are seeing, the boards in the market, that's only a front view. But now, a lot of these Bahraini entrepreneurs are operating on online and small way, and they opened the shop also. So, the new entrepreneur is coming up
in a different style, and they
are understanding the market, understanding the situation.
And of course, the times have also
times
changed,
have also,
isn't
yes,
it?
Yes,
technology.
And even the younger generation of the old jewelers are entering the market in a big way. So, if everyone maintaining their own segment, everything is okay. The collapse or the competitiveness of unhealthy competitiveness, it is there, here, there. Definitely it is there like every market, But still the market is very healthy. Mm-hmm. The only market I feel in during this corona epidemic period mm-hmm. doing good is jewelry market, just okay. to keep it in mind. Thanks to ladies.
What's the secret behind it?
Well, I don't know, most of the ladies are free at home and you know, okay. they're not traveling, no foreign trips.
Okay, but then...
They are enjoying shopping.
Okay.
What about online shopping.
Huh? What about the funds? They need money too as well.
Of course, that is what they are managing. That is their talent.
Mm, okay.
Right?
Okay.
And you know, our main inspiration is ladies.
Okay.
Without them, there is no nothing in the world, especially our trade. Right?
Okay.
They are the one appreciating our work, our style, you know.
Right, okay. That's one good credit to women out there who yes. have an eye for pearl. And so let me also touch upon that. You noticed the change in the new generation, and especially in Bahrain, coming back to the pearling in Bahrain. I think Bahrain has brought in a lot of changes to the scenario, the latest being the Danath,
yes.
isn't it?
Yes.
So I'm sure you can touch upon that, like how much, because when you compared with the Gulf of Manar and Bahrain
bed,
it's we have to talk about the leaders, the
yes.
rulers, how they have protected the heritage,
yes.
isn't it?
Yes. As I told,
I think was the Crown Prince Prime Minister's pet project.
That's right. That's his vision and his pet project. We as a me personally as a jeweler.
Yes, yes.
I was from.
And I think you were very closely associated with the project as
that's
well.
True. If I
remember.
That's true.
Yeah.
And it is our dream. It came true. And I should say the 100% credit to the Prime Minister,
yes.
Sheikh Salman. I think without his vision, this kind of big Danath is not possible. But at the same time, His Majesty's direction in this matter, even they were not doing this now. They were doing this kind of vision and the things happening last several years. As I told you, this is 72, the law is passed in Bahrain. Now, immediately after Sheikh Isa Allah Rahma, when he took over as a Amir, this law is passed in 73, I think, that Bahrain, you can deal only in real pearl.
Okay.
So, grandpapa, grandfather.
Such a vision, isn't
such
it?
Such a vision.
The vision, yeah.
And passed to His Majesty King. And then now Prime Minister. This is not something, you know, we are not seeing something new. We are developed with that kind of vision with them.
Yes, yes.
So they are coping with our dream by doing this. It is like a proud for me to say that we are in such a management. Not only in trade. You have seen in corona
in
time,
all the other, yes,
one of the
yes.
best managed
Bahrain
state.
Bahrain stands out,
so,
indeed.
So I'm particularly now I'm concentrating on my trade. There was a lot of mess when Bahrain was not having this facility long time before.
Slowly Danath is how old now? 4 years?
Now it's 4 years. Before that there was a laboratory. Was under Ministry of
Industry and Commerce.
It was also doing very good. Then almost Danath came in and the ministry facility was closed down.
Okay.
Danath came in as a semi-corporation, okay, under Mamta Lakat.
Yes.
So it is also doing excellent. And now it's in 4 years period it put his leg as a international facility
yes, yes, yes.
for pearl. And now they are trying to go for diamond and color stone also.
Okay, great.
Yeah, that's
great.
A good news.
Diving deep into the stories of pearls in Bahrain is businessman Mohammed Hussein Malim joining us on BizTalk this evening. Let's take a short break.
We'll be right back.
Welcome back to BizTalk. Joining us this evening is certified gemologist and businessman Mohammed Hussein Malim. We were just talking about Mr. Malim's business side, and I cannot but remind that you had been on various committees at the BCCI, the Bahrain Chamber, especially on the pearl and the gems and the Asian traders, etc., etc. That, in fact, shows how popular and how important you are to the business community. Moving on to Malim, the man, the human, the social side of yours. You've been the vice chairman of the Indian Community Relief Fund. You've been at the helm of affairs at the Indian Club for two tenures. And you are the founder, patron of the Tamil associations, and as well as the Bharatiyas. Yeah. Two different sides, you know, a businessman fully into this rich and expensive tales of pearls, gems, etc., etc. And on the other side, you have a human being. My interaction with you, I've always seen you with people out there, with the community in need. Was this there in you always, or did you develop this over the years?
Well, the first year I came here, as I told you, 82. From 82 itself, I connected with social work.
Okay.
Maybe it's inborn character of me or my father also like that.
Where are you from, sir?
I'm from South India, Tamil Nadu.
Where exactly?
Exactly, it's called Nagur, the Nagapattinam district, where the Velangani, Nagur.
Okay.
So my father was one of the best social worker, as much I know. And the family history also goes towards helping others. I am not an individual. I always consider I am a team person in Bahrain also. So from 83 onwards, we were started in a small way, on Tamil association. Later, it came into being of TASCA. Tamil Mandram, it's called Tamil Social Cultural Association.
Tamil Arts and Social Cultural Association.
Yeah, that's right.
TASCA.
Yeah.
And I think it's one of the few registered associations under the Social Development
That's right. And after that, we established again the Bharatiya Association.
Yes.
But if you ask me which one you will remember more, I would like to say two things. One is my association with Ambassador Gill.
Yes.
We mean the sense me, and hope you remember C.R. Nambiar.
Of course I do.
And Ambassador Gill. We three people sit together many evening, sometime up to 10 o'clock, 97 and 98, to pin down the current ICRF. You know, this is second version.
Okay.
The previous version, there was an ICRF. There was the same amount we had, but it was taken out to help to Latur earthquake,
okay.
I think in early 92-93. That was a big mistake that time. So from that, the whole activity were stopped. So Ambassador Gill thought of bringing it back, another association, ICRF.
Mm-hmm.
So this has happened, that I spent a lot of my time with Ambassador Gill, me and equally Mr.
Nambiar. Yes.
So we worked out, we in a new association, that is one of my golden moments, that ICRF now what you are seeing. Even I can quote, if you don't mind, I was asked by Ambassador Gill, what position you want to take? I told him, no. As we bend down a structure, if I pick one position, it looks very selfish.
Okay.
So I refused to take any position in the first managerial council. Later, I was given a position as vice chairman. I worked. This is one golden moment of my life. Second thing I want to say that in 2005, I don't know whether you remember, there was a biggest incident happened in Bahrain as layout. Your garment factory in Salmania was closed down.
Okay.
Over there, just like that. Mm-hmm. It was not expected. 1,300 people were working at that time.
Mm-hmm.
Around 200 other area people, our Indian community, 1,050 to 1,100 around. The owner, it's called a light lifestyle garment factory. It is no more, so we can quote the name. The history is very important. It is 2005. It was closed in May. So Indian Embassy was dealing with the situation, and our social workers were dealing with that. But suddenly it went into very violent side. The laborers, it was very hot, humid summer that time. The laborers came into embassy and it went violent. They started to push people, social workers. I don't want to name them, all of them here. And also even they tried to touch our embassy staff also. Because they were thirsty and hungry. They were not, they don't have salary. Last 3 months, salary was not paid. There is no canteen for them. And the canteen were closed. They are just totally left out in the street. So around 300 people walked from Salmabad on that scorching heat to Indian Embassy, the World Embassy. So after matter went into ugly turn, after 1 month time passed, Ambassador Bhaskar Kumar Mitra, one fine evening, the same day, I think June 3rd, when this ugly thing happened in front of embassy, he called me. I went there. There are other officials also, ICRF and all those people. I was the vice chairman at that time, but I was not involved with this situation. Embassy was trying, and also some, you know, there are close people always with the embassy.
Yes.
I don't want to name them again, they were doing. So Ambassador Mitra asked me to take charge of the situation. If anybody can do, it's only you can do. The word I remember. I took this charge. Around 1,050 people. I went next morning to them. I spoke in front of them. And the same day I arranged to reopen their canteen. I collected some money from my contribution as well as from others. Even I remember BKS at the time, Mr. Varghese, you always mentioned the people who pay. Bharan Kerala Samajam paid 1,000 and Taska paid and my friends paid. So we collected 1,000 in just 2-3 hours period. And we started the canteen facility. One of the nice gentlemen, I want to mention this good people, his name was Kannan. He's a just normal person who was running the canteen. He came forward to run the canteen. You pay later, sir. Now I will run the canteen. So we started to feed them. First, we felt they are a little bit cooling down. Then the facility was very poor. You know, the labor camps. This is a U-shaped building. The middle was the sewage. It was overflowing.
Okay.
I have to deal with these people with this condition. So I did immediately. I brought lorries to take out the sewages. I cleaned that area and we started to give food. Then Ambassador Mitra was handling this matter on my back. He's given me full authority to do whatever you want to do. You tell me what I have to do, I'll do. So 2 months period from December, June, one by one we opened up. We contacted the company in America who were buying the garments from them. It's called Gap. Still it is there. They are supplying military codes to American military. And we contacted them. They are the main buyer from this company. So they forwarded 85,000 dinar, but it is very late. Before that, we approached Abdul Nabi Al-Sola, helped us with Ambassador Mitra. We approached Prime Minister Sheikh Khalifa,
the late Prime Minister,
who forwarded 120 ticket. Are you, do you know anything about it? And one stroke he has given 120 ticket. Later we paid from this money. And then we sent 300 plus people to India.
Okay.
600 people we got local
employment.
Job, employment. So when I was closing the canteen, I was closing the camp 2 months, it is me and my friends. So one of the wonderful people where I always, I told you, team spirit. They were with me. And then when we close, only 7 people left without finding a job and not prepared to go to India. So we said we cannot continue further. We closed the camp. We left 5,000 dinar from this 85,000 dinar. The money paid back to whoever we have to pay, including the Prime Minister, all paid back. And the donation which we collect, they refuse to take it. Me or my friends, or we didn't pay to Kerala Samajam. That is as a donation. This from the 85,000 dinar, the loans like canteen owner, this and that, we paid. I left 5,000 dinar in the account of ICRF. From this money, then I went on holiday. 2 months I worked day and night. This is a glorious moment. I think that something I did, and I protected this matter. I didn't publish. I didn't give to newspaper. At the time, you were not in GDN. I think Soman baby. It is one of the moment that I still remember. It is something we can do it if we plan properly and with the help of those good souls in Bahrain. This is one of the biggest moment in my life. And the second one in social life, I wanted to mention that Corona period. When this COVID started, March 1st week itself, I sent a letter from Bharati Association, a letterhead to Sheikh Isam, His Excellency.
By the capital governor.
The capital governor, by pointing out, because I had some kind of, visiting them, some kind of rapport with them. So by using it, I sent a letter that we are closing down everything in Bahrain, the labor is going to be in trouble. So we should try to organize some help for them from the government side, because this is a huge problem, private entity cannot do. So only government can help them. Immediately I received a reply from them that we are considering this. You are not first, we are considering this. Very soon they came up with their own idea. Before they coming up, we started to distribute from whatever possible from our side, 10 kilo baggage we bought for 1,000 people.
Food, the ration kit.
The ration kit. We started before anybody even thinking of starting. I can say proudly, we have record for this. Early in March, we can say March 25th itself, our food ration was started to deliver. At the same time, slowly, all others joined, and then governor office also sent their supply to us, like they sent to everybody, Indian club they sent to Kerala Samajam. Even I asked all other associations, when I sent such a letter, I didn't keep quiet. I called Indian club president, I sent information to Kerala Samajam, please send such a letter. This is the time we have to act.
Yeah.
So they also obliged, they sent letters. So the action immediately, governor, something I should appreciate him for anything.
Indeed, capital governor, Sheikh Hisham, we can never forget.
He's the best human being I come across in this view. So he immediately went into action. He started sending food for every association to distribute, and we did it with utmost care. We didn't look into they are Indians or they are Bangladeshis or this, who are hungry. So we gave them, and as well as in Ramadan came, and they called us to distribute the food kit, or the cooked food. Whole 1 month in Ramadan, we distributed 1,400 per day. 18 people with 18 car involved with this, with the two volunteers. We went nook and corner of Bahrain. And the whole month over, we distributed 40,000 cooked food. This is given by, again, I say, Ministry of Interior, but with the initiation of
Sheikh Hisham.
The packaged ration we given 2,500 total, including Indian Embassy give us, and this also from governorate plus from ours. Other than this 40,000 food we distributed. This is where I can say personally I'm getting a kind of comfort to my
satisfaction.
This is not individually possible.
It's a teamwork.
I myself went along with these people sometime, but there are people, fantastic people with me.
Oh yes, last year I think showed us a true team spirit.
Yes, you were following us also.
Yes.
We were sending the information to you. So this two movement that I don't want to go more detail onto it, this is the two movement I want to always cherish. And if such a chance come in the future, definitely I'll be there.
Right.
To helping the people. That is my, other than this, what you call that social things, the clubs, Indian club as you mentioned it. I enjoyed as a president for 2 terms, then the starting of TASCA and Bharati Association. Again, whichever way possible, we are reaching people to help.
Correct.
So yes, particularly on Tamil side, because there was no registered association for Tamil. So we concentrate on that, we succeed, 2 associations.
Right. And also the Malayalis or the Keralites form the major lot, isn't it?
Yes, of course.
And in that, the magic, I would call, the Tamilian brilliance is always lost, because Tamil culture is so live and so colorful, isn't it, with a lot of richness in culture.
Yes.
And tradition.
Yes.
I think both TASCA and the Bharatiya Association
yes,
brought that
but
forward.
One thing, I cannot compete with Malayalis on this point. It's not a compliment for you, but it's a true. I used to say in many meetings, okay, I don't believe in incarnation. If it is one given an option, I want to be a Malayali.
Malayali, oh my God. That's
because by seeing these people,
okay,
you see, I am involved with Indian school also. You must know that. I am very much involved,
yes,
in Indian school currently. In the last 25 years when my child entered into it. Wherever one situation comes, the one who stand in front is Malayalis. No one coming, even 100 meter away from them, no one you will see.
Okay.
This is not my just words, my experience. When we are collecting fund for ICRF, when Ambassador Gill, as I told you, there was a meeting, a fundraising meeting organized by Ambassador at Palace in Hotel. I think it is 98 or 99. There are big, big business people were called in. The most of the contribution, small, small contribution, but it accumulated a big way from the Malayali community.
Okay.
But we know the names here in Bahrain. There are big names. That's which I don't know.
Thank you. That's very humble and modest of you, because I wanted to credit your community and you used it to
No,
credit.
No, no, it's not like that.
The
I'm
other
not.
Community.
It's wherever opportunity comes to speak the truth, I will be there. I'm telling you, this is not because of you are talking about my community. You have given a chance for me to say.
Right.
Thank you very much.
Thank
That's
you.
Why I said this is what my own experience.
Okay.
It's still today in social life. 70% or 60% people are
Malayalis
with me.
Right.
Of course, my Tamil guys are there, but majority of them Malayalis.
Right. Thank you very much, sir. Though you did not mean it a personal compliment, I take it as a personal compliment because
most
I'm a proud Malayali
most
myself.
Welcome. Most
so tell me about your family.
Well, it's something very lucky for me. I can say happy always, and they are very good. I have 4. Boys,
okay,
not 4 wife,
okay,
only 1 wife. And they are all with me.
In
their
Bahrain?
Choice.
They are here in Bahrain?
There are 3 in Bahrain now, 1 is studying in India.
Okay.
All the 3 joined the business after finishing their higher educations on their own choice. So they are with me. I mean, our family business now going to other next generation.
Okay.
Slowly, slowly they are taking over.
Good.
And we are all living together.
Right.
All the in-laws, you know, it's very difficult, the daughter-in-laws living together.
I think one of those days.
Yes, I'm very lucky,
you know,
on this matter.
Changing times,
and happily living together.
Good.
Living together is different.
So all the 3 sons who are here, they are married?
They are married.
And they are here.
And
okay,
they are here.
Okay.
They are in the business. And what I can say, I'm very happy about my wife and very proud to have one like that. It's again not just a word, just feeling from the heart.
Okay.
So you... If you can concentrate on other things, if peace at home.
Peace at home, yeah, yeah, exactly.
In business
and the
credit
goes to the family.
Yes, that's
sure,
very important.
Sure.
So that way, I'm very lucky.
Al Siraj, the name comes from?
It was originally our shop business in Malaysia, I mentioned to you. Lighthouse.
Oh.
The name of the business in Malaysia is Lighthouse. You know Lighthouse.
Yes.
When we try to register Lighthouse, there is somebody has the registration. So Al Siraj is something connected with the Lighthouse, Alauddin Magic Lamp.
Okay, okay.
It's called in 2-3 names. You know, Arabic one word has 36 name, and one name will have 36 words like
okay,
this. Al Fanus, Al Siraj. So we took the name.
Okay. Al-Siraj. And what about Al the Mualim.
No, Al Mualim is my family name. Mualim is my family name.
Like
Mualim, actually it is a Mualim.
Okay.
When in India, you are everything going to be, you know, Indianized. When it's Tamil, Mualim is original our family name.
Mm-hmm.
So we are 600 years before migrated from Yemen. Our history says we are migrated from Yemen, Hadramuk area. So the Mualim name came along with that migration. You know, the Mualim is an Arabic, it is a teacher, captain, and a huge group of people carrying this name as family name.
Okay.
I think Syrian foreign minister or somebody Mualim is there.
Okay.
In Saudi, you can see big group Al Mualim Jewelry,
mm-hmm.
and Egypt there is a big group Al Mualim. So this is Al Mualim is my family name. So we registered one business in the name of Al Mualim. This is how we got it.
Right. So that was the human side of businessman Mohammed Hussain Mualim joining us on BizTalk this evening. Let's take a short break.
The exclusive franchisee of Cochin Kala Bhavan in Bahrain. With over a decade of existence in Bahrain, exclusive online regular classes have started for classical dances, music vocal, instrumental music, cinematic dance, Kathak, Zumba body fitness, karate and yoga, drawing, arts and craft, children's theater. For more information, please call 39096845 39094806 38852397 or visit www.bahrainmediacity.com. iMac Cochin Kala Bhavan.
Welcome back to BizTalk from BMC Global Live with businessman Mohammed Hussain Mualim. So, as we come to the last segment of the show, we discussed about your business side, your social side, you the family man. When we spoke on the business side, you spoke about the new generation businesses. What is your opinion on the new generation social workers? Like, we have, the community is growing, the needs are different, the times have changed, though you touched upon the pandemic, but it's not like the 80s that when you started and right now. Like, how do you see the difference, especially social work is something where you need to be selfless?
Yes, that's what I wanted to add if you asked me what I can. In the social side, the whole scenario is now changing.
Mm.
What we saw 80s, 90s, the social people,
it's not anymore. Yeah.
But I can see lot of selfless people.
Mm.
In the 80s, 90s, you see people, they put themselves in the front to show they are doing things.
Oh, okay.
I'm sorry, I'm not meaning anybody.
Mm.
If I think you should have, you one of the senior also in Bahrain, you should have noticed people themselves boasted that I'm doing this, I'm doing that. There are kind of people. Now I notice lot of young generation, Indians as well as Bahrainis, they themselves make teams and they go collect food from 5-star hotel. I saw some groups when, you know, lot of food get wasted in 5-star hotel, they collect the food, they're carrying to the needy people in different pockets of Bahrain.
Hmm.
I was totally astonished. And they are not bothered about any
publicity
or things. It looks very bright for me.
Mm-hmm.
One of my son also involved in this group.
Mm.
And the approach is entirely different than what we had before.
Mm.
That 80s, 90s generation, even at 2000. It is big change is happening. Definitely big change is happening. And they are not publishing, they are not announcing anything they are doing. Quietly it is happening. And you see this 80, 90 generation totally disappeared. Mm.
Mm.
Right?
Mm.
Totally disappeared. The seniors, one or two left like me.
Hmm.
But now I see my younger brothers in the association. They are taking over in a big way. They are giving their time, their life. They doesn't want to be in the limelight.
Hmm.
I am the only face now.
Hmm.
Now I am, say, around 60, 60 plus. I cannot go to the street to work. But I have a team.
Hmm.
That team, the way they work, I always thanking God for giving this kind of people. All youngsters. Hmm. They are in the street. We just say planning and they are doing everything. So, it's a very positive feeling I have.
Mm.
The current generation doing things without publicity, without politics, they are doing in an excellent way. So, it is something if you feel, when you ask the question, maybe I misunderstood. So, there were a lot of people in social arena before, now not much. The reason is, the current people that doesn't want to
Definitely I did not mean that there weren't many, because as I told you before, 2020 showed that the team there
yes.
are people
yes.
But I was just asking you, how can you trace the difference from the 80s?
This is the difference.
Yeah.
This
yeah.
is the difference. As I told you, distributing 40,000 food is it a mammoth work? But the team which worked never come up in the field publicly. We did the job. Like
and
that in every area. I'm not only talking Tamil. I'm talking it almost in Barani society. The two society I'm always looking into it. Okay, Kerala society not much on this matter, by Indian and Barani society. They are also doing lot of work. This whole lockdown passed in Bahrain without a single man sleeping hungry.
Hungry, yeah.
Just imagine, nowhere else. I don't know how rich country like America, Europe, or you know what happened in our own back India. But here, that much help came. We are one of the small, tiny tidbit of this whole story. So I'm mentioning this. The reason is not to say that we did this, but we enjoyed this. There are hundreds of organizations did this. Private people did this. So it's a future is well saved when we consider this kind of social work, the younger generation character, and some people even offered money to us without they doesn't want to mention their name. Even 1,000 dinar I received from a Bahraini gentleman. He said, no, where you take my name? This is the people who are going to lead us in the future in social arena.
That was very reassuring to the future generation of social workers out there, coming from a veteran like you, sir. What are the challenges that you have come across in this field?
Well, the one biggest challenge we come across, you remember Gulf War,
89 to 92,
when Saddam Hussein taken over Kuwait, everything became standstill in Bahrain. You know that. All the people, especially in my trade, most of them were expatriate, the manufacturer. 99% were expatriate. Only in the retail you can see Bahrainis. But in manufacturing side, it is mostly expatriate, other Pakistani and Indians. They were all closing down. They are trying to go back. They bothered about their safety. When everything becomes standstill, and people like me supplying to the manufacturer. Just imagine, nobody will pay the to the case business. It's all credit. Once they finish their job, the jewelry, once they sold, they will pay to us. That was the biggest challenge. I was suffocated, almost suffocated.
Okay.
If I don't know if some people in my place, they will call it a day and they will go back. It's a real challenge. Almost all my capital and I have to pay for my supplier all in the market. Market were closed down, people are going back. Imagine. Mm. I don't know to say the amount what.
Mm.
But I stood there very much. Almost 3-4 months I was fighting with that. And my real encouragement came from one gentleman. Maybe you will not expect the name. Sheikh Muhammad bin Sheikh Isa's brother.
Oh,
who
okay.
was my advisor that time.
Okay. Right.
And he was visiting my shops in 89-90s. When I was almost breaking down, he stood with me. He was encouraging. I mean, some good words. It was one of my best moment of my life. That
rather emotional, maybe.
Emotional.
I can see you getting emotional.
Yes,
about it.
And yeah. He was with me. Even I reached home in India when the war starting, I received call from him from my office. He visited me. He found nobody except one staff, two staff that time. He said he called me. He said, "In the Kof, you afraid run away from here?" I catch flight in 3 days. I come back. That was operation. At that time, it's called War Theater, Bahrain.
Mm-hmm.
Only one flight from Oman coming to Bahrain evening time.
Mm.
So I took the flight because of his one call.
Mm.
I came and I called Sheikh, "I am here." It is a kind of big challenge for me. I rebirth to me, I can say. But I stood strong. Many people helped me. I mentioned Sheikh Muhammad. Many people helped me, not financially, no, moral support. Still there are my friends there who stood with me with their support. So I managed it. And we stood very strong. It took for me to re-come to the level where I lost. But thanks God, that is a big challenge. I used to say now when Corona came, when people were talking about Corona, I said, "See, first Corona we passed in 89.
Yes.
It is a very dangerous situation. You are here at the time.
No,
everything became standstill.
Mm.
We don't know what will happen tomorrow. I never thought going away from Bahrain, even on that situation also. I went because there was second delivery for my wife. That's what I went, whereas I received a call from Sheikh Muhammad calling it. In fear I went.
You're right. Okay.
I left everything. I said, "Okay, let go. I think God will take care of everything." I come back to say to him that I am back.
Okay.
That is one challenge. Almost I am broken.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But I stood with my leg very strongly. I continued. This is
very, very nice, very interesting chat, sir. You've been talking everything about your business, your social side, your family, and such emotional moments. It was indeed a great evening chat, thanks to such platforms, isn't it?
Of course,
what
of
BMC
course.
Has put
I should say,
in such a time.
I should say thanks for Mr. Francis Kaidarath and BMC.
Where people get to hear such inspirations.
Yes, definitely.
And you have to stand tall and true to certain calling. And that is what I would take back from what all you said. And
I
think it was great of you to mention few names, very important names. They all deserve it, be it Ambassador Gill or Mr. Nambiar.
Yes.
Right, Sheikh Mohammed, Sheikh Hisham. They all deserve it.
Definitely.
All deserve it.
And Bhaskar Kumar Mitra.
Ambassador Mitra.
Definitely.
So many people.
Yes.
And as you rightly pointed out, teamwork matters.
That's true. That's true. They are all traveling with me since last 40 years. You know, Mr. Abdul Qayyum, Mr. Kabir, one gentleman passed, Mr. Pandian. There are so many people who are standing with me on this kind of work. Always, wherever I go, you can see them.
Right.
They are also same my character. They never, even I said, explain to you this garment factory matter. We never publish anything in the newspaper.
Mm-hmm.
But I saw people coming in, standing with this labor, taking photo. That photo appeared in the newspaper. it is like, you know, I am blessed with people. I am very most important thing. If you ask me what you want to say, I am blessed with very good people.
That's very nice.
Honest people, they are always with me. We are traveling 40 years. I didn't have any bad experience with any particular person trying to cheating me.
That's very generous of you. Maybe that's because you were.
Maybe.
Because it's all a
maybe,
give and take
maybe,
matter.
Maybe.
So one last question from my side.
Before that, I want to say thank you.
No, we are yet to close. This
okay.
is one very important question.
Okay. Okay.
Because you said like you deal with products catering to women, isn't it? Pearls, gems, diamonds. I started with that. Let me conclude with it. Which is more close to your heart? Pearls, diamonds or gems? Dealing with
pearl.
What gave you more?
More pleasure, I can say pearl.
Pearl. Why so?
Pearl itself, it's a kind of beauty. We used to believe when you see the pearl, when your mind is little bit stress or tension, if you see a pearl,
stress
it will
relief?
Get stress will relief.
Okay.
It's not like I'm not trying to say that it's a kind of promotion or anything.
Oh, okay.
This is a kind of way. I'm dealing in gems.
Oh.
I'm dealing in diamond. If you can say I'm selling more diamond than pearl, the truth is. But still, to my heart, the pearl. One small information I want to register in this interview. In our nikah, you know, the nikah,
marriage,
marriage, we used to give, meher to the
meher,
girl.
Yeah.
We don't take what you call that money from the girl side.
Okay.
Okay?
Mm.
That meher in our family till today, they are mentioning only in value of pearl.
Okay.
So it is in the blood.
Mm-hmm.
In the blood. That is what the pearl, maybe that is the reason I am connected with the pearl or we love the pearl. You asked a question to the right person because I am the only one here in Bahrain.
Mm-hmm.
In Bahrain at the moment, dealing with all these three in a big way.
Okay.
Not like, you know, selling retail, diamond wholesale, gems wholesale, pearl wholesale. So I choose pearl. Very dear to me and as well as dear to ladies also.
Okay. Thank you very much, sir. It was an honor and pleasure to have you on this platform. It was very nice chatting with you.
Okay. And I would like to say that I am really very happy to attend this interview. It is another reason it's you.
Thank you very much. I take it.
And
as,
you always, I notice your way of presenting news and taking social side responsibility for that. I really appreciate and my salute
thank
to you.
Thank you,
and
sir.
And I thank all the team of BMC. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
That was some pearls of wisdom and some shining success stories like the diamonds and the gems from businessman Mohammed Hussein Malim, who was with us on BizTalk this evening from BMC Global Life. Until we meet next week with yet another guest, this is Raji Unnikrishnan signing off. Good night. Mr. Malim, thank you very much, sir, for this beautiful evening. May I now call Francis Kaidarath, the Chairman and Managing Director of BMC, along with Praveen Krishna, the Media Head, to present a small minute.